this time. But did you write the music together?
Yeah, I mean,
I'm mostly on at our on our own, and then met up and matched with.
But we also arranged. Most of it together, you know, and also Tony wrote a song, like a full song, and
that was something different.
Yeah.
Did the drums first and made riffs.
Which is not really the regular way of writing a song, but it's really helps to get a different perspective of on things.
So when Silenoz wanted to include a bit of. So when he wanted to include a little bit of keyboards, you had to hold him down?
I had to stop him, yeah.
Yeah, because as far as I remember, there are no keyboards on this album.
No keyboards.
Really old school.
Yeah, but the next one.
Yeah, we only have
all keyboards. All keyboards.
The Wunderlich.
But seriously, this album is very brutal and it's like a fist in your face. What was it that you wanted with the album when you wrote it? Was it just to get let out some steam or
no?
I wanted to heat it.
That's why we heat it up.
Yeah,
one against the other.
No, it was just to make songs in a good old way.
Yeah, well, brutal way. Yeah, just. Fucking unleash,
things that
unleash
we
hell.
Liked for years.
Yeah.
There was no.
Instead of unleashing hell, like drinking and partying, we actually put it into actual playing. I think that shows a good way of how we party.
And it wasn't like, okay, now we have a band and we shall play this type of music. It was just natural.
Yeah,
we wanted to.
It's instinct. Instinctual.
Yeah, not thinking about genres or anything.
No.
But still, it's like quite safe in the death metal genre.
It goes without saying, but at the same time, we didn't really want to label the music anything, but it's no secret, obviously. Mm.
But one thing is that the sound is it's not like these modern, hyper-fast death metal bands. And but it still, it's not like this old, very genuine but sloppy Autopsy style. It's like a just brutal death metal kind of.
Without being labeled.
Without being.
No, but that was.
that you are on the label, right?
Yeah, I guess we are. So. Yeah. Last time I checked.
Yeah. That was our goal as well, to try to sound as analog as possible, but with modern equipment.
Yeah. And actually, that's a challenge in itself, because you want it to sound good, but not too good.
I read something about when Mark did the vocals and did the echo. There was something special going on there.
He has his own echo plugin, the old school echo plugin. When he did like, he was like. The vocals here, like did it in like that. So that's also a plug-in, but we didn't end up using that one.
No, that's the hidden bonus dog track.
Yeah.
So you've done a couple of videos, we believe. Tell us about that.
The first video was more like just putting music to. Live footage when we played Wacken last year, which was actually, I don't know how many other unsigned bands that play Wacken, but it was like a really good thing for us to do, obviously, because you get to portray the music for other people. And while Motorhead was playing the main stage, we had like probably 2,000 people in the tent, so. Also, really, really good thing. But the new video is not that the other one is really old, but the new one is more like a conceptual type of thing, and it's extremely brutal. It's like a snuff movie.
Lads, continue.
No, we shouldn't.
Okay.
The purpose of Insidious Disease?
He made us do it, not the haunted. Make sure you get this.